teachers, judges, and my dear student managers. I, Suraj Jaiswal.
And I, Ritesh Shende.
And we are going to give an induction presentation on next. Yeah, the first and the foremost, most familiar question. Pehchana kon? Okay.
Anyone of you know kon? These two faces?
Anyone? Okay. These two faces are the faces of entrepreneurs, a greatest entrepreneur, not a greatest, but a good entrepreneurs. Next. The founder of Taxi for sure, Mr. Aparamiya Radhakrishna on left side and Raghu Nandan ji on the right side. They started a company, Taxi for sure, and our topic is case study on Taxi for sure.
Okay. Let's talk about objective, why we chose this topic. First, it's a 8-day of induction presentation, and I saw a tremendous type of presentation, and mostly I saw basically most of one comes with a successful stories. So we both chose this downfall story because we want to convey the message that behind every failure there is a learning, and every failure taught us how to overcome the problems. So these are the contents that we are gonna cover up. Introduction. Before introduction, I want to tell you one story how this startup comes up in the market. So yeah, there's a two guys first met in the NIT engineering college, and after passing out the engineering, they went to their own path, and after the couple of years, the destiny again brings them together, and they again meet in IIM Ahmedabad. So yeah, they after their MBA degree, post degree, they get their dream jobs with great packages. So one of the day, they meet together, they hang out in a bar, and one of them said that aata tera bhai taxi chalayega. So after that, another guy gets stuck this idea in its mind, and guess what, guys? These two IIMs guys comes with a big bang idea in the market.
And from that point, on June 2011, the company came into existence, that's Taxi for sure. They invested from their pocket about 8 lakhs of rupees to start up that company in a 100 square feet office. And later on, only in the first year of their progress, they get the investors investing approximately 237-240 crores of rupees in their just first year. The business model is they launch an app called Taxi for sure, and they were either buying the taxis or taking on a rent from the taxi operators on a fleet. There were approximately 1200 taxi operators in the Bangalore itself, Bangalore city. They founded Bangalore city, and each taxi operator was on an average having 10 taxis with them. They were taking on a rental basis, hiring a drivers with deposits of 15,000 to 25,000 rupees, and taking a commission of 15% to 25% from each rides, charging less fare and incentives to the drivers to take their interest in their market.
So coming up with a SWOT analysis, strength. Operators have a better control over the driver, that they give all the freedom to the operators, that they have a better control on the driver. They actually give a friendly environment to them. First into the Nano service, and when the Nano is launched, firstly the Nano was first introduced in the cab service, which is comes under the Taxi for sure. Then rapid expansion, and at that time the Taxi for sure first come up in the business in 2011, and at that time they have a great extent to their business, and they have a rapid expansion coming through C scheme. They are the first in the market that they introduce the city to city schemes, as we saw that Ola and Uber can provide the services inside the city, but these guys are the first in the market that they provide their rides from city to city. Coming up with the weakness, drivers misbehaving depicting the brand image. So it is basically the online platform, and reviews is the first content. First, if the reviews are bad, it basically make the brand image down. So misbehaving the drivers misbehave affects the brand image. And opportunities, our organized market is huge, and hence the potential is high. When the taxi for sure comes up in the market, the Ola was already there in the market, and the taxi for sure idea comes with a very unique idea, and they sustaining in the market very at the peak of their ideas. Increasing the internet penetration and the smartphones. So it's basically introduced in the market where the internet penetration is high, and when the internet, when the users of internet is going high, the subscribers is also high. Shifting of customers towards the convenience creates the huge demand and threats. Competitors, there are huge competitors already in the market, like Ola, Uber coming up. And similar name taxi. The name taxi affects the brand image. It's matters the name taxi that make it the brand down. So it's the market share, sales. We make it a pie chart of where you can see the TFS in the 10% and Ola in the 46% and Uber in the 16% and Mega in 5%.
The revenue of the company. From fiscal year 2012 and 13, there was a profit of 3.02 crore, but something bad happenings was taken place at 2014, at the beginning of 2014, which affecting the brand image of taxi for sure. Firstly, the similar name and other competitors also. There was a loss of 17.4 crores rupees. At the same time, Ola was also bearing the losses of 34 crores in that same year. Next.
Yes, for the reason for downfall. Entry of Ola cab with a new strategy. As Ola is introduced in 2010 and taxi for sure is introduced in 2011. And for making the market of taxi for sure to down, the Ola introduced their new strategies in the market, like they make their fares down, and they coming with a new feature in their app, that is Ola wallet. And at that time, this feature is very new, and they provide also incentives to their drivers. And second, the frequent strike of local taxi drivers, like taxi for sure guys hires the taxi from the market, and if there is a recession or something, the taxi for the taxi drivers can go to the can went on the strike, and this strike results in their business. Controversies of rape and harassment cases, like in 2011, there is a harassment and the rape controversies gone held in Delhi, and this is because and these controversies was held with Uber, and this controversies affects their brand image also. Investors and banks losing the trust on the companies because of these controversies. The investors and banks also losing their trust, and they won't able to provide the funding for the business.
Yeah, the strategy applied to overcome. In 2014 August, the company invested 67 crores of rupees in their business as a last payment, and the bank balance was also only that amount for the company. They invested full amount. They reduced their fares by 20% with competition to Ola, and raised the incentives of the drivers to get back the drivers which was gone to Ola when Ola get introduced in Bangalore in 2014 beginning. And the results, the strategy worked out for TFS, and they were getting 35,000 to 40,000 rides all over India. They were acquiring 47 cities, taxi for sure. But the company was facing a losses of 150 rupees per ride, as the incentives was greater to achieve the interest of the drivers. Cash was burned out in mid of December 2014. Because of that, the company loses all the profit or giving their drivers or staff the income payments. The company was carrying a huge amount of liabilities. Next. Later on February 2015,